The FBI just went nuclear. Full investigation opened. John Solomon has been the gift that keeps on giving to conservatives across the country, and last night he delivered us a colossal Christmas present that has certain people panicking. As many are aware, the Clinton Foundation appears to have been nothing more than a money laundering and racketeering scheme for Bill and Hillary Clinton, who used it to sell government influence, among other things. Ever since the New York Times published an expose about the organization in 2015 detailing how millions flowed into it during the infamous Uranium One deal, fair-minded people have demanded an investigation from the government into how it was allowed to happen. Writing for The Hill, Solomon revealed that while on the surface nothing seems to be happening with the crooked crock of criminals pretending to do Christ's work, behind the scenes there's some major happening. And it's not good for anyone involved with the Clintons. In fact, the Justice Department has opened a fresh probe, utilizing fresh faces, into the sham charity to determine which laws were broken, including those against pay-to-play and other corrupt activities. God has answered our prayers. From Solomon, emphasis added. The Justice Department has launched a new inquiry into whether the Clinton Foundation engaged in any pay-to-play politics or other illegal activities while Hillary Clinton served as Secretary of State, law enforcement officials and a witness tells The Hill. FBI agents from Little Rock, Arkansas, where the foundation was started, have taken the lead in the investigation and have interviewed at least one witness in the last month, and law enforcement officials said additional activities are expected in coming weeks. The officials, who spoke only on condition of anonymity, said the probe is examining whether the Clintons promised or performed any policy favors in return for largesse to their charitable efforts or whether donors made commitments of donations in hopes of securing government outcomes. The probe may also examine whether any tax-exempt assets were converted for personal or political use and whether the foundation complied with applicable tax laws, the officials said. Further, it appears as if the FBI agents have a specific mission in their new probe. One witness recently interviewed by the FBI described the session to The Hill as extremely professional and unquestionably thorough and focused on questions about whether donors to Clinton charitable efforts received any favorable treatment from the Obama administration on a policy decision previously highlighted in media reports. The witness discussed his interview solely on the grounds of anonymity. He said the agents were from Little Rock and their questions focused on government decisions and discussions of donations to Clinton entities during the time Hillary Clinton led President Obama's State Department. Oh, this is getting good. Just yesterday, we reported that the Justice Department has opened a new probe into Hillary's handling of classified information while she was Secretary of State, which included using a private, unsecured email server in the bathroom of her New York home, a server that at least five different foreign operatives gained access to. Hillary's acolytes freaked out about yesterday's news, and their reactions to Solomon's report wasn't much different, suggesting they're entering full panic mode as they realize their house of cards is crumbling beneath them. Let's call this what it is, a sham, former Hillary spokesman Nick Merrill said. This is a philanthropy that does life-changing work, which Republicans have tried to turn into a political football. It began with the now long debunked project spearheaded by Steve Bannon during the presidential campaign. It continues with Jeff Sessions doing Trump's bidding by heeding his calls to meddle with a department that is supposed to function independently. Except that it's not a philanthropy that does life-saving work. In fact, the nation's most trusted charity watchdog called the Clinton Foundation a slush fund and put it on a watch list of problematic nonprofits, the New York Post reported. The Clinton family's mega-charity took in more than $140 million in grants and pledges in 2013 but spent just $9 million on direct aid. The group spent the bulk of its windfall on administration, travel, and salaries and bonuses, with the fattest payouts going to family friends. On its 2013 tax forms, the most recent available, the foundation claimed it spent $30 million on payroll and employee benefits, $8.7 million in rent and office expenses, $9.2 million on conferences, K-12 conventions and meetings, $8 million on fundraising, and nearly $8.5 million on travel. None of the Clintons is on the payroll, but they do enjoy first-class flights paid for by the foundation. Yikes. No wonder Merrill is having a coronary right now, he's knee-deep in all of this mess. As Solomon notes, the Clintons' shady practices have been publicly known for years, yet nothing has been done. For years, news media from the New York Times to the Daily Caller have reported countless stories on donations to the Clinton Foundation or speech fees that closely fell around the time of favorable decisions by Hillary Clinton's State Department. Conservative author Peter Schweizer chronicled the most famous of episodes in a book called Clinton Cash that gave ammunition to conservatives, including Trump, to beat the drum for a renewed investigation. However, between the Justice Department's announcement yesterday and Solomon's report today, it looks like Hillary and her cabal of corrupt criminal co-conspirators had best be seeking some really good legal counsel, because it doesn't look like the Trump administration is going to allow them to get away with their borderline treasonous activities any longer.